Hello my dear children, welcome to Learner's Planet. Children, in this session we will study about health and hygiene. So children, this is session 2 in which we will learn about the importance of food in our diet and which are the important food which we include in our diet. So we will study about the food groups. Alright children, so in the previous session we studied about health and its importance, and this is a session about food and its importance, right? So let's start with this session. Yes children, do you know that what is meant by food? Yes. Food is any substance which is consumed to provide nutritional support to our body, right? And we eat different types of food, right? But what is actually food? It is any kind of substance and it is consumed by us, by the living beings, because it provides nutrition, right? And because of this nutrition, it provides us the energy to do all the kinds of activities. Alright children? So children, the substances that are needed by our body for proper growth and health are called nutrients. And these nutrients provide support to our body and gives energy to our body to perform all the activities. So children, we think that we all have to do is just go to the grocery store or the restaurant for food, and so we are spoiled, right? So children, this is not so easy. From where does the food comes? You must be thinking that we just have to go grocery store or the restaurant, right? But it is not the correct one. It is not the thing. Actually, anything we want to eat at any time is available. But we tend to forget, children, that where the food actually comes from. Yes, the food does not come from the restaurant. Fruit or the food does not come directly from the grocery store. But we get it from the plants and animals. Alright, so you cannot tell that we get the food from the restaurants or hotels, but we get the food from plants and animals. So we can say that we obtain our food, different types of food, from plants and as well as animals. Okay children, like we get bread and cereals from wheat, corn or grains. We also get all the dairy and meat items from animals, right? So we get food from plants and animals. And you will also be amazed to know that many plants and plant parts are also consumed directly as food. And even the seeds of plants are also a very good source of food for the animals, right? But not for us, because we cannot digest the seeds of the plants directly, right? So whenever the seeds germinate and grow into a big healthy plant, they provide us with all the type of food, and that food is eaten by us, consumed by us, right children? So always remember that plants and animals are very useful source for us, right? So we should conserve them. Okay children? Children, let's see some of the examples of some food, right? From where do we get? So we will see some of the foods which we get from plants and also from the animals. So let's see. Yes children, this is a chart which is showing food and its source. So children, this is a very common food chart. Like we get vegetables from plants, we obtain eggs from the animals like duck, hen, etc. Then we get fruits, various kinds of fruits from the plants, not from the animals. We get milk from animals, right? Like cow, buffalo, sheep, etc. Then we get meat from the animals, right? Like meat from the animals like, yes, goat, and we also eat chicken, right? So all that food we get from animals, then we get honey from the animals like insects, like honeybees. Then we get juice, fruit juice or any other type of juice from the plants like fruit juice, okay? Then we get jam from the plant. It is not a direct source. We do not get directly from the plants, but it is a type of plant product, right? Okay, children, so we saw this table. So are you clear with this now, that what are the basic things which we get from animals as well as plants? Children, we eat fresh, frozen or canned fruits and vegetables and juices, right? Even our favorite food, pizza, is also a combination of grains, meat and vegetables, right? So plants and animals are very important for us. So children, all the dairy and meat items are produced on land where the animals are fed with grains. So we can say that animals also depend upon the plants. So plants are very useful for us, right? Children, in ancient time, people used to get food by hunting, gathering and agriculture. But nowadays, it is supplied by the food industry. But what is actually our food industry doing? It is also depending upon the agriculture, right? Almost all the foods are of plant or the animal origin, right? As you can see, the source over here, right? Like cereal grain, it is a staple food that provides more food energy than any other type of crop. And other cereal grains are maize, wheat, rice, etc. Right? So many plants or plant parts are eaten as food, and there are about 2000 plant species that are cultivated for food. Alright? So all these food items are very important for us, and even plants are very important for us because there are many plant species that are cultivated for food, right? And the seeds of plants are also a good source of food for animals, as we discussed, including us also, because they contain nutrients which are necessary for our body. We cannot consume it directly but indirectly, right? So animals are used as food directly or indirectly by the products they produce, like milk. And even meat is a direct product taken from an animal which comes from their organs, right? And milk is a direct product which comes directly from the animals, is it? Right? But cheese, butter, they are not obtained directly. They are processed. So that is why we call cheese and butter as milk products, alright? Even birds and animals, other animals, lay eggs. So this is also a direct form of food available to us, right? So even bees produce honey, right? A nectar which is produced from flowers. This is also a popular sweetener in many cultures. So this also we obtain directly. So there are many food sources or many food items which we obtain directly or indirectly, but they are obtained from the plants and animals. Alright children, so always remember that plants and animals are very much important for us. So we should take steps to conserve them rather than destroying them or cutting the trees. Alright, now we will start with the main topic, that is food groups. So let's start with the food groups. Yes children, we eat a variety of foods, right? Like you can see in this picture, right? This person, this man is eating corn, which is the largest or very important cereal grain, right? And a beautiful lady is serving milk and even cookies that are also a part of our diet. Milk is very important for us because it will build strong bones, right? It will make our bones very stronger, right? And even our teeth. So milk is also very important, right? And you can see here in these pictures, right? What you can observe, all the persons are having their meals. So meal is also a very essential part of our diet, right? We should consume every type of food group in our meals. Like we can get food from plants and animals, right? And we consume various types of fruits and vegetables, green leafy vegetables, even we consume meat, right? So this meat contains a very high amount of protein, so we are consuming this also. Then we consume and we have pulses also, right? So we include almost every type of food in our diet which is very essential for us, and so we can say that we eat a variety of foods, right? Now let's see what is actually a food group. Yes children, a food group is a collection of foods that share similar nutritional properties, right? So what is actually meant by this? What is meant by nutritional properties? Yes, the food which provides nutrition for our body, right? So that our body can get energy and it can perform every type of work, right? So that is why we say that a food group. Group means collection of many types of variety of foods, because we eat variety of foods, right? So a food group is a collection of foods that share similar nutritional properties, alright? And that is why a food pyramid has been shown over here, right? So children, this might be a new thing for you. What is actually a food pyramid, children? As you can see in the picture, it is a triangular shape or a pyramid shaped. So we can say that food pyramid is triangular or a pyramid shaped nutrition guide, right? As it is divided into many groups. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 groups. And it is made to recommend the intake for each food group. That how much quantity of each food group you should consume in your diet, right? So what is important for you? What is the important food group which you should consume more and which you should consume less, right? Each food group is very important for us, right? Each food group shares similar nutritional property, right? But what should be consumed less and what we should consume more is also very important for us. So we should know this. So children, as you can see, the top one, this is the pyramid which shows the categories. It is divided into each food group. Like the first one shows the fats, oils and sweets, right? And you can hear, even you can see here bread also, right? So this is a line which you can see here, right? Right? So what is it showing? The first one is showing that fats, oils and sweets are over here, right? So this shape is very small in size, right? As you go down, the shape of or the size of this pyramid increases, right? So it is increasing as you are moving downwards. So what is it actually showing? Why it is made in a pyramid type? Why it is triangular shape? Because on the upper side, if all the types of food which has been shown should be consumed less, right? And as we are going down, it is showing that the last one, which is the major one. So this is the size of this food group is very large, and that is why it is showing that we should consume this food group more as compared to the others. Alright, so the first one, this half one, the left one, is showing that fats, oils and sweets should be consumed less in quantity. The right one shows the calcium and vitamins. You should also consume calcium and vitamins, right? Till the adult stage, till 20 years or 22 years, you should consume milk daily. That is very, very, very much important for you, right? After that, you can reduce that, but not, you should not completely lack the food, right? So you should consume the food which is actually calcium and vitamins also, right? The second one is showing the milk and yogurt. Milk and yogurt and cheese is also very important for our body, right? So you should consume more than fats, oils or sweets, right? So you should have 3 servings every day. Alright, then the third one is showing, the third one over here of the pyramid is showing the cheese, right? Also the nuts, right? So here are the nuts, nut group, then meat, poultry, fish. You can see here, fish, meat, poultry, these are the non-vegetarian food, right? So you should also consume non-vegetarian food and the nut group, right? So these are nuts. So this should be also 2 servings, right? So you should consume 2 servings of this diet, right? Then the next one is vegetables. Green leafy vegetables are very much important, and also the fruits, green leafy vegetables, and the things which are made from the cereals, right? So cereals are also very important for us. So you should consume it more than the nuts, non-veg food, milk and yogurt, and even more than the fats, oils, sweets and the vitamin group of foods. So you should consume green leafy vegetables and fruits daily. Then the last one forms the major one, which is including rice, pasta, fruitified cereal, bread, vegetables and even exercise. As you can see, shoes over here, dumbbells, and even playing sports like ball. You can see here ball, then a table tennis, right? And you can see here, this is also a type of exercise a person is doing. So you should consume green leafy vegetables. You should also consume the cereals like rice, maize, wheat, right? And their products. And you should also do exercise. So are you clear with this pyramid, right? This is a pyramid. This is a food pyramid which shows actually the collection of foods, right? So this is a food group pyramid. Alright children, so why is it important and why it is made? Yes, it is made because it serves as a general guide to food choices, that what choice of food should we consume more and what should be consumed less. And even children, do not forget that 8 servings of water is also very much important for our diet, right? So this food group pyramid was actually first published in Sweden, and it is used to show the foods that make up a good diet, right? So if you will follow a pyramid, then you will be able to achieve a healthy mind and body throughout your life. Alright children, so do follow the food group pyramid. Alright children.